Hello everyone, I am Assistant Professor S.V. Shezai from Agricultural Engineering Department. This session we will start with sprayer. Sprayer is a machine to apply the fluids in the form of droplets. Okay. Now the sprayer is used for the following purposes or functions. So first one, that is application of herbicides to remove the weeds. Okay. Then application of fungicides to minimize the fungus disease. Okay. Then application of insecticides to control the insect pest, etc. Okay. Then application of micronutrients on the plant for their better growth. Okay. Now the main functions of sprayer are, main functions, let's see, first one, that is to break the liquid into the droplets of effective size. Okay. Then to distribute them uniformly over the plant. And after that, third function, that is to regulate the amount of liquid to avoid excessive application. Okay. See the different parts of the sprayer. So first part, that is nozzle body. Okay, that is shown in the figure A. Nozzle body, it is the main component on which other components of a nozzle fit. Okay. Then next component, that is swirl plate. Okay, this is swirl plate. It is the part of the cone nozzle which imparts the rotation to the liquid passing through it. Okay, so through this swirl plate, the liquid starts to rotate and then it passes through it. Okay, then next component, that is nozzle cap. This is nozzle cap. Okay, and it is the component which retain the assembled part in or on a nozzle body, and the nozzle disc or tip may be integral with the cap. Okay, so the tip, nozzle tip, lies below the cap. Okay, the next component, that is spray gun. It is lance from which the spray is readily adjustable during the operation. Okay, then spray boom. Okay, so this part is spray gun and this part is spray boom. It is a spray lance with a spray nozzles fitted to the head and mounted at the right angle to the lance. Okay, then next component, that is filter. Okay, there is a small filter present in the nozzle body. Okay, and this filter is used to remove the suspended matter larger than a predetermined size from the fluid. Okay. Now the next component, that is overflow pipe. It is a conduit through which excess fluid from a pump is bypassed by the action of relief valve or pressure regulator. Okay. Then next, relief valve. It is an automatic device which opens when the pressure of the fluid or gas reaches a predetermined valve. Okay. After that, pressure regulator. It is again automatic device to control the pressure of the fluid or gas within the range of settings. Okay. The next component, that is cutoff valve. It is a mechanism between the pump and the nozzle to control the flow of liquid from the sprayer, and this can be operated by the hand. Okay. The next component, that is nozzle disc. It is a component containing the final orifice of the nozzle, usually a cone nozzle. Okay. Then nozzle boss, it is a lug on a spray or a spray lance to which a nozzle body or cap is screwed. Okay. Then nozzle tip, it is the component containing the final orifice of the nozzle, usually a fan nozzle. Okay, fan nozzle, then cone nozzle are the types of the nozzle. Okay. Then spray lance, a handheld pipe through which the liquid reaches the nozzle mounted at the free end. Okay. The types of sprayer. So first one, that is bucket type sprayer. Okay. This equipment consists of a single or double pump which may be placed into an ordinary bucket containing a spraying solution, and it is very light, easy to handle, and develop sufficient pressure to spray the small gardens and low trees, etc. Okay, this is the diagram of bucket type sprayer. Okay, so this is nozzle, then this is spray lance. Okay, here is the handle, then here is the spring, This is the pump barrel, okay? And here is the footrest. Then this is the bucket, plunger rod, brassets, bucket assembly, etc. Okay. Now the next type of function, next type of sprayer, that is knapsack sprayer. Okay. Knapsack sprayer, this is the common type of sprayer, is provided with a pump and large air chamber permanently mounted in a 22.5 liter tank, and the apparatus is quite useful for spraying small trees, shrubs and row crops, and one man can spray about 0.4 hectare in a day, and thus spraying about 90 liters of the liquid. Why the knapsack sprayer is called as knapsack sprayer? Because we carry that knapsack sprayer as a like a bag, so it is or on our back, so it is called as knapsack sprayer. Okay. Now there are different components of the knapsack sprayer. So first one, that is a trigger ball. Okay. Then to operate or to control the flow of the spraying liquid. Okay. Then there is a pressure control valve. Then this is the pump. Then here is the pump handle. Okay. Then there is a lance, and this is nozzle holder and nozzle. Okay. Then this is delivery tube. Then lid and spray tank. Okay. Now the next type of sprayers, that is a compression sprayer. It consists of an air pump mounted in an airtight chamber, which is filled of about 3/4 with the spraying material. Okay. And the pressure is developed by pumping air into the tank, and the spray is forced out under the pressure, and the tank capacity is usually varies from 14 liters, and frequently pumping is to be done to maintain the pressure. Okay. And this is the diagram of compression type sprayer. This is the filter, then this is hose pipe, then here is the lance. Okay. Then here is the handle. Then this is the tank. Okay. This is pump cylinder and nozzle, check valve, footrest, etc. Okay. Now next type of sprayer, that is hand atomizer. This is the smallest type of hand sprayer used to treat the plants in home garden or nursery, and to apply spray in the houses. Then in this instrument, compressed air is allowed to pass over the end of the tube, which the other end, and dips into the spray material. Okay. Then blowing air sucks the material through the tube and blows it out through the nozzle as a mist. Then last sprayer, that is engine powered sprayer. These machines are usually portable type. Since the sprayer is driven by an engine, there is no variation in the output and pressure and performance of the PTO shaft of the tractor, besides being pulled by it. Okay. Then dusters. Okay. Duster is the machine to apply the chemical in the dust form, so it is called as dusters. And dusters make use of air streams to carry the pesticides in a finely divided dry form on the plant. Now first type of duster, that is plunger type. Okay. It is the simplest type of duster with a small piston, and the piston drives a current of air over the dust in the hopper, and the dust is carried away through a delivery spot. Okay. Then small hand pump dusters of this type are available and suitable only where the area to be dusted in small, like vegetables or flower gardens, etc. Then next, knapsack type dusters. It is the duster with the powder container on the back of the operator, and that dusters have hopper through which a current of air is blown to pick up the dust, and the air current is produced by the lever operated leather blows, and shoulder straps or carrying straps are generally provided in such a dusters, like a same knapsack type sprayer. Okay, and they can be easily carried in the field, and the dusters are suited for again small areas. Okay, Then rotary type of dusters. Okay, it is a duster with a hand operated rotor in front of the operator, and for spraying tall crops, more force of delivery is required. Hence, rotary dusters are preferred. Okay, this is important. Then dust is fed from a hopper into a current of air produced by the rotary fan, and it's blown out through the delivery pipe. And most of the models have steering device which is actuated by the fan crank to ensure a steady flow of the dust. Okay, then the rate of the delivery can be regulated by a valve below the hopper, and the delivery force is controlled by controlling the speed of the fan. Then next type of duster, that is power operator duster. Power operator dusters mainly consist of power driven fan, a hopper, then delivery spot, etc. And the fan creates strong airflow which causes the dust to blow off from the hopper to a considerable distance, either vertically off or horizontally. And the direction of the dust is regulated by a movable delivery spot suitably fitted with the unit. And these type of dusters are used for the large areas. Okay. Now this session is finished here. So thank you for listening.